Hi folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to on removing buckets from MinIO using .NET. And in this video, we're using .NET version 6, and we're going to be deleting a bucket off of play.min.io. That's our online sandbox for anybody who wants to use MinIO and just play around with it a little bit. And all of this is going to be running out of Visual Studio 2022 for the Mac. And just a couple of items here on our agenda that we're going to take a look at. The RemoveBucketAsync method is how you're actually going to remove a bucket, delete a bucket off of min.io. Now, the issue is whenever you remove a bucket, it's got to be empty. So I'm also going to get into a little bit of the RemoveObjectsAsync method, which allows you to take a collection of objects and delete them. And I'm also going to talk a little bit about versioning considerations. But let's take a look at our code for this. So here is our standard min.io demo code that we've been working with in a few of our how-tos now. What we've got here is a simple task that takes our bucket name.net demo bucket and then tries to go find it to make sure it exists and then tries to remove it. Now that operation only succeeds if the bucket is actually empty. Now you may notice that we've got a remove bucket args in here. The remove bucket args object is very, very simple. The main thing you need to hand it is the bucket name. So I've really just created the remove bucket args right where I needed it in this case. So all I'm going to do now is I'm going to try to run this. The main method connects out to our play.min.io environment. It attempts to run this and it handles any exceptions. So you can just look at the code here. So let's go ahead and run this .NET.run. And we do have an error. So min.io comes back and says, hey, the bucket you tried to delete isn't empty. You have to delete all the versions of all the objects in the bucket before you can actually delete it. That's because this is a versioned bucket. Now, if I wasn't working with a version bucket, I could just delete the objects and go because there's no residual versions laying out there. But if I delete a version of an object, the previous version can be reinstated. So I want to make sure that I have deleted all of my versions. Now let's take a look at this. If I do an MC, which is our min.io command line client, I'm going to do an ls with the versions out on play.net demo bucket. And as you can see, we've actually got a few versions of things out there. I've got my hello world, my image PNG, and I've got about 7 versions out there now. So that's a lot of stuff. I'm gonna have to spend an awful lot of time writing a lot of code for this. Well, it turns out I actually have already written the code. Let me just show you how this is going to work. So let me scroll down a little ways. I've got this empty bucket method that I'm gonna be calling here. And what this is going to do is it's going to take a list of object names that also include a version ID. So it's a list of objects and all of the versions, and that gets handed into a remove objects arg, which then gets handed to our remove objects async method. Now I've also included some code here to handle any errors and so on and so forth, but generally once it's done, it's gonna pop up and say, hey, I removed all the objects from my bucket name. Easy to do. Now I could just sit here and stand up tuple after tuple after tuple of both the item name and the item version ID, but rather than doing that, I've actually written yet another method that calls list objects, which you may have seen in a previous how-to. And list objects here, I'm getting all of the recursive down into the bucket if I have prefixes. I'm getting all of the versions. And then for each of those items, I am adding a new tuple, which is the key, which is our object name, and our version ID, that's obviously the version, to our all objects object that I'm going to then hand back as my list of tuples, okay? So I've also got a little thread sleep in there just to make sure that it finishes its job before we hand it back. So then that's what gets called here when I list all my objects out, and then it's going to remove all those objects based on that list. So now all that's left for us to do is actually add the method call empty bucket. And this takes a min.io client and it takes a bucket name to actually do the deletion of all the objects in there. And since it's asynchronous, I'm going to do a wait while it deletes all of these objects and their versions. And we will just let that go. Let me go ahead and save this and we will run this down here. Let me do a clear so you can see what's going on. We will do a .NET run. And there you can see it's removed all the objects from .NET demo bucket, and I've even removed the bucket itself. If I run this a second time, I'm going to get the flag that basically says, hey, the bucket does not exist. There you go. And that's everything that we've got on deleting a bucket from MinIO. You got to make sure that it's empty first. You got to make sure that all the versions are gone as well. But once you've got all that done, it's very easy to remove a bucket from our test environment. I hope you've enjoyed this how-to. If you want to connect with us, you can connect with us with any of the methods that you see here on the screen. You can connect with us interactively on minio.slack.com. And last but not least, you can always leave a comment here on this video. We'll see you for the next how-to.